Okay, right here what we have is a capacitor, okay? The electricity comes in a wave form, and what the capacitor does is it translates that wave form into a specific pulse pattern. Similar to like Morse code would be a code. Well, this particular pulse pattern is what works well for the compressor. This is your run capacitor. And this particular one is a 35 microfarad capacitor. You always want to use the same capacitor, rated capacitor for the system that you're working on. As far as the voltage on the capacitor, this particular one's I think a 370 volt. You can go up in voltage, you just can't go down in voltage when you use the capacitor, but you always want to use the same microfarad capacitor. Now this little capacitor is a start capacitor for the fan. And the fan motor is kind of funny in that it can't start on its own. When the power comes in, the power can't start it on its own, and what the start capacitor does is it kicks it off so that the fan can start spinning. Now if you came up here and you saw that you turned your unit on and the compressor turned on and the fan motor wasn't turning on, sometimes you can give the fan a little push with a pen or screwdriver or something, and if it kicked on, that would mean that your start capacitor was bad and that it's time to replace this little capacitor. Now sometimes you'll see these capacitors, and I'll try to find a photo and put it on this video, but where there'll be three ports on the capacitor, and the center one is usually the one that's for the fan capacitor. It's just an alternate way of wiring this here, where this is internal to the run capacitor with the start cap. Now this particular fan capacitor is a 5 microfarad capacitor. Again, you always want to use the correctly rated capacitor for your systems.